Hi friends, in previous classes we have created a website, we designed a website, okay, we also wrote some content and also done some SEO for it. Means we have gone through on-page optimization. Okay, on-page optimization means, what is on-page optimization? We'll take some measures or actions within our website, okay, so that we can bring our website to the top of SERP results. This is known as on-page optimization. Okay, so we have did all these things in order to bring our website to the top of SERP results, right? So in order to display our website in SERP results, if someone searches for our website should get displayed in those results, right? So in order to display like that, we have to submit our website to Google. In order to display our website in SERP result, we have to submit our website to Google. Though we don't submit our website to Google also, okay, as we learned about crawling, Google only will come to each and every website and crawl all the website's information. It will happen. Whatever website it may be, if it has taken a hosting, then Google only will come to our website and it will only crawl our information and data. But it may take some time. We can't assure how much time Google will take in order to crawl our website, because there are millions of websites, right? There are huge number of websites. Google should come to each and every website and crawl the content from it, right? So it may take some time. We can't expect how much time it may take. It may take 1 day, 2 days, 1 week, 2 weeks, whatever it may be. So if we want to make this process fast, if we want Google to crawl a website as soon as possible, then we have to submit our website to Google. Okay, so where we should submit our website? I'm saying that we have to submit it to Google. Then where? So we have to submit our website to Google Search Console. It is a tool. Okay, this is also known as Google Webmaster Tools. Okay, both are same. Google Search Console and Google Webmaster Tools, both are same, right? So what is this Google Search Console? Okay, so this Google Search Console, here we can submit our website to Google, and also it gives all the information about our website, how search engines are interacting with our site, how many visitors are coming to our site, whether people are visiting our site on mobile device or from a desktop, okay, how our site is performing. Like this, we can get various kinds of info about our website from this Google Search Console. And also the main thing is, it also helps us to fix our website errors. If our website has any issues or if there are any errors in our website, we can fix it with all those things with the help of this Google Search Console or Google Webmaster Tools. Okay, clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Right. So now let's go to Google Search Console. So we'll go there and we'll ask Google to crawl our website and index our website. Indexing means giving some number in the search. Crawling, indexing, all these things we learned, how Google search engine works, right? We'll go there now. So, right, simply go to Google and search for Google Search Console. So you must have a email. So with the help of that email, we'll be creating an account. So I'll suggest one thing, always create accounts, Google, this Google accounts, okay, with same Gmail ID only. It may be Google Search Console, or it may be Google Analytics, or it may be Google Ads. Use the same mail ID. So that if you want to open all of them at the same time, no need of logging out and logging into different Gmail accounts. If you create one Gmail account only, if you use same Gmail account only for all the Google accounts or Google products accounts, you can access them easily. That's all. Right. Simply click on Startup. So here itself, you see here itself, it is say Search Console tools and reports help you to measure your site's traffic. Means how many visitors are coming to your website, how your website is performing. It will help you to fix issues and make your site shine in Google search results. Means it will help you to bring your website to the top of the search results. Start now. So there are two things here. If you see, one is domain and one is URL prefix. Okay, so we can submit our domain or subdomains here, right? So if you have a domain and if that domain has many subdomains under it, okay, then you can submit your domain here. Okay, so all URLs, okay, the URL may be, or your website may have HTTPS or may not have HTTPS, whatever it may be, you can submit here. So, and also it requires some DNS verification. It says DNS means domain name server verification. It needs, okay. So, what is this URL prefix? Okay, if you have a simple URL or if you have only one subdomain, okay, you people are having subdomains, right? If you have only one subdomain like that, you can submit your website here. If your website has too many subdomains under it, if you are having like such kind of things, you can submit your domain. Now I'll submit my website here. Okay, I'll submit it under URL prefix. You people also go for URL prefix only. So simply go to your website and then choose your website URL. Okay, so I have put my website URL and you have to go here and simply place it here. Okay, so click on continue. Now it will go for a verification process. It will ask you to verify whether you are the rightful owner of that website or not. So now it is asking me to verify whether you are the correct owner or not, like that. Okay, so this verification method has various things. Okay, you can verify through HTML file. Okay, so here you have to download the file and then you must have access to the cPanel. There you have to give this file and all. So other method is HTML tag. This is one of the simplest methods. Simply it will give you a small tag with, you should copy this thing and you should paste this thing in your website before the first body section. Okay, it should go into the head section and you'd paste it before the body section. Next thing is Google Analytics. If you have a Google Analytics account, then also you can verify this thing with the help of this account. Okay, so what is Google Analytics and all, I'll discuss later. If you have a Google Tag Manager account also, you can directly connect thing with Tag Manager account. Okay, we'll be discussing about these two things later. Next thing is domain name provider. Means you might have bought your domain from GoDaddy or Postgator, Bluehost, whatever it may be. You have to go to your service provider where you bought your domain and you have to make this verification, right? So among these things, I'll go and choose HTML tag itself. It is bit easy. Why? Because it is bit easy. I'll simply copy this tag. Okay. See, it is saying me copy the tag below and paste it into your site's homepage. It should go into the head section before the first body section. Okay, so you have to paste this in the head section for the first body section, right? So now I'll go to my website dashboard. So if you have an idea about coding, then simply go for appearance, theme editor, theme header, and then you can paste this tag. Otherwise, simply go for settings. You must have downloaded a plugin called insert headers and footers. Okay. I don't have this plugin, so I'll go and install it. So now search for insert headers and footers. This is the plugin. See, it is a simple method. Install it. Click on activate. So don't forget one thing, until you paste the code and verify it, don't close this box. Okay. After you paste the code, you have to click on verify so that this Google Search Console verifies whether we are the rightful owner or not. See, verify ownership kind of thing. So don't go for closing this thing. Don't click on done before verifying the whether the tag has been placed or not. So after the plugin has been installed, go to settings. Then you can see this plugin here. Click on this thing. So place the code in header. So after placing the code, simply save the settings. Okay, settings saved. Now I'll go here and I'll verify my ownership. So right, ownership verified. We have placed the code correctly. Right. So now go to property. Here property is nothing but your website. Okay, whatever website you have added here, it is known as a property in Google Search Console's terminology. Go to property. So this is how the Google Search Console looks. Okay, actually it is the new thing, right? Now itself I have set up the Google Search Console for this thing. That's why it is not showing me any kind of web search clicks and all. Okay, so don't worry. Now what I should do is I have to submit my website to Google. Okay, so I have to go to my post or article which I wrote. So if I want Google to crawl it immediately, okay, if I want Google to crawl this thing immediately, now I'll go here and I'll simply copy the post URL, my post URL, my article's URL, and I'll go to for URL inspection. Now here you have to place your URL. So whatever post you want Google to get crawled, place here and click on enter. Okay, now it will retrieve whether it has been indexed or not. So okay, so the URL has been indexed. It may take some time. Okay, in the previous times also I have indexed it multiple times. Okay, my website has been placed many times. Okay, that's why it is showing here. Okay, if you try, it might show that URL is not on Google, like such it might show. Okay, so then you have to click on request indexing. Okay, you have to click on request indexing, right? So don't forget about that thing. You can add multiple properties also, means multiple websites also you can add. So if you have two or three websites, there is no need to create a Google Search Console for each and every website. You can manage multiple websites here itself. So if you want to add a property, simply click here and simply click on add property. By this, you can add your property, whatever you want, and you can submit your website to Google. So I'll show this thing also. I'll go for Jayant thing. You can remove the properties also. I'll show that thing also. How to remove and all, I'll show. So simply I'll choose this thing. Again, you have to place that code. You have to verify your ownership. Don't forget that thing. So like this, I can add multiple websites to single Google Search Console itself. So as I haven't placed any code, so now I have to take the HTML code. And again, I have to go to Jayant's website. And I should place the code. Now simply go to settings, insert headers and footers. Now you have to place the code here and verify it. So like in this way, you can add multiple websites or multiple properties to single Google Search Console. Don't forget to verify. So now as I place the code, the ownership will get verified. Done. Go to property. So right now it is Jayant's. So as I haven't submitted this website prior, so it is showing like that. It will take some time. Go to URL inspection. Now I'll submit Jayant's article. So Jayant, you wrote the article. Go for making bolds and italics, headings, okay? Or go for on-page optimization things also. Internal links, external links, add those things also. Right. As it is not indexed on Google, it will show in a different way. See, it will show URL is not on Google. So in previous thing, my website Go Explorer is submitted multiple times. That's why it is showing like that. Okay. Initially, your thing will show like that. After that, you have to click on request indexing. Okay, so this page actions are temporarily disabled. It seems I have learned about it recently. Okay, but don't worry, it will take some time. After some time, all these things will get back normal it seems. Okay, so once you write everything, Google only will come to your website and crawl it. Okay, don't worry. It will take some time, some 24 hours, or it may take 1 hour or 2 hours. We can't assure. After 24 hours, please check once. Right. So now I'll show how to check your website, whether your website is getting displayed or not on Google also. Okay. So now I'll go to Google. So this is an article written by me. Okay, in Crunch Stories, I wrote this article. Okay. So now I'll go and check how to identify whether my thing is appearing on Google or not. So my keyword is, so based on the keyword you have to search. My keyword is blue cat paper tree fee paper. Okay, this is my keyword. If someone searches for this keyword, my article must appear. So now I'll go here. So go to Google and I'll search with this keyword. Okay, now what you should do is, okay, click on Control F and search for your website. My website is Crunch Stories, right? So in the first 10 results, okay, every page will have 10 results. The CRP page will be having 10 results. So every, these 10 results doesn't have my website. Okay, these are all Blue Cat Papers websites. Okay? See, these are all Blue Cat Papers websites. So my website is not appearing. As this is the original website, it is the right to get displayed on the top. Okay, so now what I should do is I have to check whether it is appearing in the next results or not. So now what I should do is go for settings, then search settings. So make these results per page as 100. Okay, now what will happen is in a single SERP page, you'll be displayed with 100 results at a time. Okay, so you'll be displayed with 100 results at a time. Now I'll go back. So I'll refresh this page once. See, now we are getting displayed with, okay, I'll refresh this. Okay. Yes, should I save this thing or not? Okay, I should click on save. So I have to check this thing also. Right? Now you'll be displayed with 100 results in a single page, okay? Now I'll search in which position my website is appearing. Okay. So, see here it is getting displayed, Crunch Stories. Actually, this is the thing. So, okay, I gave a wrong spelling. Okay, like this, your website will get displayed. Okay, you have to search with your website, right, so that you can easily find out where your article is. This is the article. So in what position I'm getting displayed, so I have to count from here. It is somewhat difficult, so you can go for a extension, Chrome extension called SEO Quick. Okay, so what you have to do is simply go for Google and you have to search for SEO Quick Chrome extension. Okay, you have to add this extension to your Chrome. So simply click on add to Chrome. Okay, as I already added this thing, it is showing me remove from Chrome. It will be shown as add to Chrome. Okay, so I'll enable this thing. So this will look like this. This SEO Quick extension will look like this. So now simply click on this thing and I'll enable this thing. Okay, you'll get an option like this. So and also you'll get some numbering, but the numbering is overlapping. Don't worry. This is 1. This is 2. Okay. So now I have to check in which position I am. So, okay. Again, I'll search with my website name. So I'm in 11th position. Okay. So I'm in 11th position. So this is how we have to check where your article is getting displayed. Okay. Before I was in some 30th or 40th position. Okay, now I'm in 11th position. Why? Because so SEO is a consistent process. We have to post consistently. We have to do SEO consistently. Then only we'll come on top. So these are all Blue Cat Paper original websites. So they'll obviously come on top. Next one is Hindu. This is very old website and it has very good SEO ranking. It has wrote many articles and it has been since years. That's why it is getting displayed on top. I think according to this article, being in 11th position is somewhat good, right? Okay, any doubts till now? Have to check your website's position or not. You have to go for an extension called SEO Quick. Any doubts?
No doubt, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Right. So, like this way, you'll be having many keywords, right? You want your article to get displayed for multiple keywords, right? So, if it is neem, yesterday we wrote about neem, right? So, if someone searches for benefits of neem, my article should appear. If someone searches for nutritional benefits of neem, then also my article must appear. So, if someone searches for uses of neem, then also my article must appear. So, in this way, try for different keywords, okay? In this way, go for Google, try for different keywords and determine what your position is, okay? In what position you are getting displayed and all, please check once, right? So, you can also check whether your website is crawled by Google or not also, okay? So, what you have to do is please make a note of this, your website name, you should give your website name. My website name is goexplorer.xyz. So it is crawled before itself. So see, in this way it will show. Okay, DigiReady, digital marketing. I have been giving many names for this thing. So that's why it is showing like this. Okay, SEO, Candid. Okay, I have used all these things. So previously it has crawled all these things. Once your website gets crawled, it will be showing all these things. What things got crawled from your website and all. Okay, so to check whether your website got crawled or not, okay, have to give your website name. Get your website name. So if you want to check when it is crawled, at what time it is crawled and all, you have to go for your website name. So I'll check that thing also. So in this way it will show, okay? Your page got crawled on 23rd October 2020. My last crawling date was 23rd October, okay? On this date, it was crawled recently, okay? How recently your website got crawled? In order to know this thing, you have to go for your website name, okay? So please remember these things. These are also important for your interview and all, okay? So now what you people should do is, okay, you have to write an article. Please do on-page optimization for it. Add headings, meta title, meta description, internal links, external links, bolds and italics and all. Okay. And once you do on-page SEO, please submit your thing to Google Search Console. And then you have to check your position on SERP. In what position your article is getting displayed on all, you have to do. And also you have to get an idea for what keywords your website is getting displayed. Okay. So you have to also check, you have to try all the keywords. Okay, you might have thought about some keywords, right? For these keywords, my article should appear. Like that, you have to search for different keywords, search with different keywords, and you have to note the positions, right? So if I search for Kavya Mandapa, so Kavya Mandapa is the founder of Blue Cat Paper. So my article should appear. So I don't know in what position it may appear. So I'll check. So it is in fourth position, see? So here the competition is low for me. It is very good that I'm appearing in fourth position. Okay, so it is the original Blue Cat Paper website. Pinterest, it is the one of the old websites, and LinkedIn is also the old website. So I'm very happy that it is getting displayed in fourth position. So based on the keyword, your position also will change, right? So you have to make a note of all these things so that you'll get an idea how to do on-page SEO. Okay, and coming to this SEO Quick, you can enable or disable it at the whatever time you want so that you'll get to normal state, right? So now I'll go back to Google Search Console and explain the remaining things. Okay, so this is the Google Search Console for my Crunch Stories blog. Okay, here in the same way, you can add multiple properties at a time. Okay, if you see here, this website has some data, right? It has been tracking some data. As it is not a new website, it has been running from past 5 months. Okay, it has some data. So here you can see what all website clicks you got and all. Okay, So total website clicks is 183. Like that, you can get an idea about these things. And also how many errors are there in your page, how many valid pages are there. Okay, there are only two pages with the errors. Simply you can click on this open report and you can check all these things. So what is this website click and the impressions? I'll give an idea. Okay, so what are these clicks, impressions, okay, and CTR. So before going to it, I'll go to this performance section, you'll get an idea. So if you see here, it is saying that I got these many clicks, 1.11k clicks, 17.1k impressions, and the average CTR. CTR means click through rate. Okay. And the average position. My average position is 15 inches. It's very good, guys. Okay. So we have been running this thing from past 4 months only, but we are getting in 15th position. The main thing is we have to do constantly, you have to post articles constantly, you have to be working on SEO constantly. Okay, and we have done only on page SEO, we haven't gone for off page SEO, that's why it is showing up in 15th position. It is good, I think. Okay, so what is this impressions and all? I'll say, okay, so impression means if your website gets displayed once on the SERP, then it is known as one impression. Okay. Got my point? If website appears, if someone searches for my website and then my website appeared on SERP results, then it is known as one impression. So how many times your page or your website gets appear on SERP, so the number of impressions will also increase. So as I shown before, okay, so I went to Google and now I searched for Kavya Mandapa. So if someone is searching for your business or your website, then my thing got appeared here. So my website got displayed here. Now it is known as one impression. Okay. So like this way, how many times it may appear, right? Based on the search results, it will be appearing multiple times. So how many times it will be appearing? It is known as impression. Okay. If it appears for once, it is known as one impression. If it appears for multiple times, based on the number, we'll say that it appeared for 10 times, it appeared for 1,000 times, like that, we'll say. Okay. It is known as one impression, right? Those are known as impressions. Clicks means after our website gets displayed in SERP results, how many clicks it got. Means how many people clicked on my result and how many people navigated to my website. It is known as clicks. Okay. So this is the difference between clicks and impressions. Next thing is the click through rate. Okay. What is this click through rate? Okay. It has a formula. Simply you can say number of clicks by number of impressions. This is the formula, total number of clicks by total number of impressions into 100, which means, so how many clicks you got for the number of times it got displayed, how many times your website got displayed in search results, and for that, how many clicks you got. Understood? Got my point? So your website might have displayed for 1,000 times on search results, right? Then for 1,000 times, how many people clicked on your thing? So if someone clicked for 50 times, now the thing will be 50 by 1,000 into 100. Got my point, right? This is the click-through rate. Please respond. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? So this is known as click-through rate. Average click-through rate. Here they are saying it as average click-through rate. Average click-through rate means, okay, so on an average, so first time you got some 5%, second time you got some 10%, third time you got 15%, like that. So 3 plus 5 plus 15 by 3. This is known as average. On average, on an average, how much click-through rate you are having, it is showing this thing. And average position. So if my result got displayed for 10 times and first time it got displayed in third position, second time it got displayed in fifth position. So based on the keyword, okay, my position also will change, right? Based on the competition will also change. So in the same way, so it is also showing me the average position, in what position my website is getting displayed. So here it is also showing me this query. This is the search query. With what query users are searching for my business. So many people are searching with the Crunch Stories. Okay, so 246 times my website got displayed and 179 times people clicked on that thing and navigated to my website. Okay, so 108 times and 59 times they clicked. So so based on various keywords they'll be clicking. So see, 369 times my website got displayed and I got 19 clicks here. So like that you'll get an idea how many times your website got displayed and how many people are clicking on your website at all. Okay, so you know about URL inspection. Here in URL inspection you can submit your website to Google, or you can submit your post or article what you wrote to Google. Okay, so if you want your website or your article or your page, whatever it may be, to be crawled immediately as soon as possible, then you can come here and you can submit it. But it is recently blocked for some days. I mean, it is not taking any request indexing option for some days. Let's wait for some days and see again. And next thing is coverage. Okay, here you can see what all errors your page has. See, it is showing me how many valid pages are there, how many pages have warnings, how many valid URLs are there. Okay, you can see all these things. Excluded. Excluded means Google itself excluded them. Okay, which means Google only wantedly excluded these pages because they are not proper. See, so URL not found, currently not indexed. Okay, so page with redirect. So this thing does not have robots.txt file and all. I'll say about that. What is this robots.txt and all? See,
yes. ever account nunchi na login chesi mana ala crawl cheyachanu.
No, that's what I'm saying. So you have to verify your ownership. Now I have placed the code in your website, right? So if I placed my code in your website, means I am the rightful owner of your website, right? Okay. I'm able to access your website, which means that is my website only, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So once you place the code in your website and you verify it only, then you can crawl. Otherwise, we can't see others' websites. That's what I'm saying. You have to verify yourself that you are the rightful owner of that particular website.
Okay,
so errors, there are two errors it seems. So it will also show me what errors are there. Okay, so all these things you have to correct all these things. Not found page, not found error. So that's why this thing it removed approximately 2.65 pages it seems. So how many valid URLs I have? So there are 739 valid URLs. All these things are valid. Okay, so none of the pages have warnings. Warnings. Okay, warnings means any warnings, you have to correct these things like that. Okay, you can also see the issues on top. Okay, don't think that your page has this many URLs. How I have this many URLs like that? Okay, every page, every post you create is an URL. Okay, even now I have created a page named Go Explore, right? Even that thing has many URLs. Even this is one URL. Health tips, this is one URL. Okay, like this, every category, every page, every post you create becomes an URL. Like this, your page or your website will be having multiple URLs. Okay, so this is about coverage. So I'll speak about this robots.txt, sitemaps, what is this canonical kind of thing, all these things I'll speak about them later in server side optimization and all. I'll give you a clear idea. So next thing is sitemaps. So sitemaps is nothing but, so in simple, we'll give a map to Google. So if our website is too large, if you go to Amazon, it will have some millions and trillions of products. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it that easy to crawl one product and show you? If one person goes and search for a laptop, okay, it will show the Amazon results, right? It is picking that laptop wala thing from those thousands and millions of products and it is showing up to you. So it is not that easy. So in order to help Google to find the things easily in your website, we'll be giving it a map, like Google Maps. So if you want to go to any new location or if you want to go to a place which we don't know, we'll use Google Maps. In the same way, we are helping Google by giving it a site map. Okay, we'll give it a sitemap. We'll discuss about it in detail later. okay, how to create it, how to submit it and all. Okay, next thing is removals. So removals is nothing but we have already indexed some pages, right? So some pages are already getting displayed from our site. So if we search for Kavya Mandapa or like kind of things, okay, my thing is getting displayed. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is crawled and it is also indexed by Google, right? So even I delete this post, I went to Crunch Stories and I deleted this post. I don't want this post to get displayed anymore. So even I delete this post in WordPress or from my website, this article will get displayed, this result will get displayed. Because why? Because it is already indexed by Google. Now if you want to completely remove any URL or any post or any article or anything which is already indexed, if you want to completely remove it, then now we have to go to removals here. Okay, now we have to go to removals and then we have to create a new request. So now we have to place the URL here, which article or which page you want to remove permanently. Okay, so you have to simply go here, you have to simply copy this URL. Okay, I have to copy this URL and I have to place it here. So remove this URL only. So once you remove this, then only your article or your result will be completely removed from Google. Otherwise it will be displayed. Though you delete from your website or not, okay, it will be displayed here. Why? Because it got already indexed in Google. Okay, so if you want to remove it completely, you have to come here, removals, then you have to remove your URL here. Okay, then only it will stop displaying your content, that particular content. Okay, so this is how we have to raise a request in order to remove a URL, already indexed URL from Google. So in order to remove any unwanted URL, you have to come here. Right, next thing is Core Web Vitals. So Core Web Vitals is nothing but, so it will show how our website is performing. It may be on desktop or mobile, how our website is performing, it will show. So I'm lucky that I'm not having any poor URLs. I have one or two URLs which need some improvement and 67 are good URLs, it seems. Okay, nice. So on desktop, how it is performing and all, you can see. And also page speed insights. So remember this thing also. Page speed insights means how your page is loading. What is your loading speed, your page loading speed? You can know here. Please make a note of this thing. So you can simply go to Google and type for it. Page speed insights. Means your website loading speed. If someone searches for your website, how much time it is taking to display. So it is good somewhat. Red means too bad. Okay, so orange means good. Okay, 72. 9200 means it is very good. Okay, it is taking some 1.5 seconds and all. So I'll say what is this contentful paint and all. Keep it aside. Okay, so report. So if you take a report, how many things needs improvement, how many things need all these things, you can see. So here also you can see LCP issue, CLS issue. Can you see that? These are these things. Okay, LCP, all these things are this. Okay, so what is this LCP and all LC? Okay, so if you are, it is showing that if your URLs are poor or it may be bad URLs also. Okay, it may be poor or as I said, it may be need improvement. Okay, some URLs may need improvement. There are some reasons for it. Okay, so this thing totally depends on, okay, user experience. When they open your page or when they come to your website, how much time your website or your page is taking to load, to get displayed. Okay, it is also much more important. Okay, so there are three kind of issues in a case. One thing is LCP issue, and next thing is FID, and next thing is CLS. These are the three issues in a case. LCP means largest contentful paint. And next thing is FID. FID means first input delay. Next thing is cumulative layout shift. LGP, these are the three things. These three errors you may face. Okay, what is this LGP issue? It is totally about loading speed, your page or your website, how much time it is taking to load. Okay, so if it is less than 2.5 seconds, it should be less than 2.5 seconds. If it is less than 2.5 seconds, then it is very good. Okay, if it is greater than 4 seconds, which means if your website is taking more than 4 seconds to load, okay, 4 seconds to load, then it shows a warning. More than that, it will go to poor URL state. Okay, so your website must take less than 2.5 seconds. See, so largest contentful paint, okay, LCP. So for my website, it is 1.8 seconds, which means it is good. It must take, okay, less than 2.5 seconds in order to load. It is, which is good. It is taking 1.8 seconds, it seems, right? And next thing is first input delay. Okay, it is totally about interaction. Okay, it is about loading, page loading. All these three things depends on user thing. Okay, user experience. So this thing mainly depends on user interaction. Interaction means if someone came to your website and he interacted with something. Okay, so interaction means he might have clicked on something or he might have clicked a button or not. So after he clicks a button, okay, so or when he clicks on something, how much time the browser is taking to open the particular page. Okay, after he clicked or after he interacted with something, how much time our page or our website or browser is taking to open that particular thing or particular page. So this thing must be less than 100 milliseconds. Okay, so it must be less than 100 milliseconds. Okay, so next thing is a cumulative layout shift. So it is mainly related to visual stability. Okay, so look and feel and all, visual stability. Okay, so though user do not interact also, sometimes the pages change, like scrolling up, showing different text. Okay, some kind of changes you may see sometimes in some kind of websites. That thing should not happen. So it is known as visual stability. Our website should have visual stability without interacting anything with anything or without clicking any button. Also, sometimes your pages may scroll up, your pages content may change. Okay, so it should not happen. Okay, so there must be some visual stability in your website. So if he clicks on something or if he interacts with something only, then the action must occur. Otherwise, it should not happen. So this is known as visual stability. So all these things are very important for our website's performance. Okay. So now it is showing me time to interact. So after 2.9 seconds, it is showing some content, it seems. Speed index, so cumulative layout shift is 0.006. It is very, very good. So total blocking time and also. You can go to simply page speed insights and you have to view your URL here. Then after you click on analyze, you can see how your website is performing. You can also see how your website is performing on desktop. It is desktop and on mobile also. So your website must be mobile friendly also. It is not that good, it seems. It is showing a score of only 40. See, so it is taking 2.4 seconds, it is taking 19 milliseconds. Okay, 3 seconds it is taking. So based on this thing, you have to improve your website. So if your website has too many plugins or if you are including too many videos, too many heavy files, this thing might happen. Okay, so more HTML tags, more videos, it will go to more loading time, it will take more loading time. That's why use optimal content. Okay, use try for going more text, embed images and videos based on your requirement and all. Don't go for embedding more and more HTML tags. Tags means there are more and more plugins, more and more codes like that. Okay, so everything will depend, everything will come under this thing. Okay, so any doubt about this thing?
No, ma'am.
Right. Next thing is mobile usability. So there are zero issues. Good. So these many URLs are mobile friendly. Okay. Mobile friendly URLs means these pages are good on mobile. your website must be mobile friendly, because nowadays no one is opening. So most of the people are opening any kind of website or any kind of blog from mobiles only. They are not going to laptop or desktop and going for it. Okay, most of the people are coming from mobile only. So mobile friendliness is also more important. But don't worry, all the websites which are built with WordPress are mobile friendly. Okay, don't worry about that. Right. And next thing is AMP. AMP means accelerated mobile pages. Okay, so one issue is there, it seems. Image size smaller than recommended size. See, it is showing like this. So you have to go to that particular page and have to change this. So in this way, you can get all the suggestions from Google Search Console. What things are going wrong? What things are going well? How our website is performing? All these things you can get to. There are two errors, and also there are 66 valid URLs, which is good. Okay, so next thing is breadcrumbs. Breadcrumbs is nothing but the URL. This is known as breadcrumbs. So if some people are from any kind of CSE background, you can know. Breadcrumbs means the URL. Here, as I said, a URL must be clean. It must be easily understandable. Okay, that is known as maintain good breadcrumbs. Okay, so valid. All the things are valid, it seems. Very good, right? Next thing is site links box. Okay, 103 valid links, it seems. Okay, there are 103 valid links. So okay, these links are nothing but like site links. Okay, you can search site links, it seems, right? Links here, the main thing about links, so almost these are same, I think. So here you can see how many external links your page has, how many internal links your page has. Okay, from which sites you are getting links. Okay, you are getting a link, and from which sites to which sites you are giving a link. All these things you can know. How many internal links are there, how many external links are there. Okay, so how many backlinks you are getting, all these things you can know. I'll explain about backlinks in detail. Okay, so simply remember that internal links means if you are giving a link within your website, if you are redirecting people within your website, it is known as internal link. And if you are giving a link to some other website, if you are redirecting people from your website to some other website, then it is known as external link. Okay, so top linked pages. Okay, these are internal links, it seems. Within the page, we have these many internal links. External links means we gave from this blue cat paper and all, I gave one external link. I'll show that link also. So this is the external link. I'll show. Give me a minute. So this is the link. I navigated people to bluecatpaper.com. So this is the external link. Okay. So like this, from which pages I have given external links, that thing also you can see. And also top linking sites. Okay. So which pages have given you external links, and also top linking text. Linking text means for which text I have given a link. Here I have given a link for https://bluecatpaper.com. For this text I have given a link. And here for startup I have given a link. This is known as text. For which text I'm linking. Okay. Here you can also see that thing. Right. You can also see all these things. Top linking text and all. Okay. So like this you can know everything. How many backlinks, external links and all. Okay. So here it is settings. So if you forgot to verify anything, you can go to settings and you can also verify here. Okay, if you haven't verified, if you forgot to verify, simply go to settings and then ownership verification, then you can verify here. Okay, so and if you want to remove any owners, I mean you want to give any kind of permissions for others or remove anyone, you can do that thing also. So you have to go to simply settings. Okay, you have to go to settings, go to users and permissions. Okay, here you can give permissions, means others also can access your Google Search Console. They can also see. So simply give their email address. Okay. Okay, you can give full permission or you can also give restricted permission. Restricted permissions means they can only view your results. They can't change anything. They can't add properties. They can't, they can't change things here. Okay, they can only simply see what's happening, how much traffic you are getting, what are the errors and all. Like this, it's your wish, you can add multiple users. Now, once you click on add, okay, they'll be getting a mail. Okay, they'll be getting a mail once they'll accept this mail. Okay, once they will accept this mail, they can view all your data here. Okay, like this, you can add multiple users, or else if you want to remove anyone, okay, you can also remove anyone. So now I'll go here and I'll show once. So now I have you have to simply go here. And you can simply click on three dots, manage property owners. So now I can simply unverify this thing. In this way, you can also remove the owners also. If you have multiple owners, you can remove them. Okay. So, or if you want to remove any kind of property, I have added multiple properties, right? I have added jn.techcourses.com, right? Now, if I want to remove that particular property, now what you have to do is you have to go to settings again. Okay, so you can simply click on remove property. Okay, so now I am removing this property from my Google Search Console. So now if I remove this property, Jayant can go and Jayant can create his own Google Search Console and he can add his code to the website. Okay, you can add his code to your website and he can run his own Google Search Console account. Otherwise, he can't run. So I'm removing this property. Okay, so after you remove this property, please go to your website and remove that code also. You have placed some Google Search Console code in a website, right? Remove that thing also. So in this way, you can remove a property also. If you don't want anything, simply go to settings and remove that property. Okay, so now, this is all about Google Search Console. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. These are security things and all. Okay, no issues detected. If there are any issues also, you'll get here. Right, so any doubts still up?
No, ma'am.
Right. No doubts, ma'am.
I'll give a small thing. So you have to do this. So you have to do two things mainly. One thing is web position analysis. The next thing is competition analysis. Right, web position analysis. So here you have to make a list here, keywords. And next thing is positions. And next thing is blog post URL. Here, what you have to do is you have to write an article. You have to submit your article to Google Search Console. And then you have to go to Google. Okay. And you have to search using SEO Quake or whatever it may be. You have to search for your article. So for which keyword, okay, your article might be having 2 to 3 keywords or might have more than them. Okay. So write all these keywords here and you have to check for which keyword in which position my article is getting displayed. And you have to place the blog post URL here. So which blog post is getting displayed in which position, for which keyword it is getting displayed. This is known as web position analysis. And next thing is competition analysis. Now here, what you should do is you have to add an extra thing called competitor URL also. So if you go to anything here, so all these are my competitors. Am I correct? The above 4 people are my competitors, right? So what you should do is you have to go again, search for those things, which keyword, which position you are getting your thing, and you have to write the competitor URL also. So in which position you are, if you are in 4th position, then you'll be having, okay, 3 competitors, right? Top 3 competitors are your thing. So you have to copy paste all those URLs here. So these two things you have to do so that you'll get an idea how to submit your website to Google, in which position you are coming, what things you have to correct and all, you will get an idea. Okay, so you can also know about more things. So if you go to your competitor URL, why they are getting displayed in top positions when compared to you. Okay, so as this is an old website, okay, it is getting displayed. This is the original website, that's why it is getting displayed. So I'll go for some other thing. So let's see this thing. So why this thing is coming in fifth position, why not the other things are coming. Okay, so if I go to this particular competitor URL, so you can go to diagnosis. Okay, so as you install SEO Quake Chrome extension, okay, you can go for diagnosis also. Here you can also see, okay, I have to, right, you can also see at what time, what is the age of the website, the age of the, based on the age of the website also, your position will differ. Okay, they might be doing SEO from years. You started just now, then how will your website come to top? So based on, you can also see all these things on top. Okay, simply click on this thing. I'll click on this thing only. So you can go for doing a diagnosis here. So simply click on this icon, iInfo, summary report. After that, click on diagnosis. So once you go there, you can see everything, what your competitor has used. See, this is the URL length. It is very good. Right, green color means it is good. Blue means okay. Red means not okay. Okay. So what all title they have used. This is the title I have used. This is 48 characters. It is optimal. And meta description, it is of 154 characters. Okay. So you might use from 160 to 300 characters, it seems. Okay. You can improve this thing. So what all keywords they have used, you can also see. And also headings, what headings they have given. So H1, H2, H3, how many headings they have used. So you can also see what headings they have used and all. Okay. Have they given all text, alternate text to images or not? Image optimization, what they have done and what you have not done. You can get an idea from this diagnosis so that you can improve them. Okay, based on that, you can improve your ranking on SERP also. So all these things, okay, schema, Twitter card, accelerated mobile pages means mobile version. The page has a valid AMP version, means mobile version is also good, it seems. So you can also see this robots.txt, XML sitemaps, I'll say about it. Okay, so all these things you can check here. And also you can go and see what internal links they have given, what external links they have, all these things you can see. What are external links they given? All these things you'll get an idea. And also see density means what keywords they have used. Okay, see what keywords they have used, all these things you can see. Second word phrases, okay, what phrases they have used in their article, all these things you can get an idea. You can also compare URLs here. Okay, you can compare this thing with your thing. And also can go to page info. Here you can see their title, their meta description, their internal links, external links and all you can see. Okay, so all these things you'll get an idea. Once you do your competitor analysis, you'll get an idea what they are using, what you are not using, why your position is lagging. Okay, so that you can improve your position and all. Okay, so you have to do these two things on web position analysis and competition analysis. So as you see, request indexing is temporary unavailable. We'll make some technical updates and it will be soon available. Okay, don't worry. You write your article, do some on-page optimization for it, and check whether their website is crawled or not after 24 hours like that. Okay, so we'll meet you in next class.